Hi, this is a question 6A. List out types of transmission lines and draw their schematic diagrams. This question is given for 7 marks, set 1, April 2018. Let us see, first define what is transmission lines and we see what are the different types of transmission lines and their diagrams. First, let us define transmission line. Let us define first what is transmission line. Transmission line is a type of guided media, used to transfer information, from one location to another. So what is transmission line? Transmission line is a type of very important guided media, so that is cable, which is used to transfer information from one location to another location. Let us see what are the different types of transmission lines and their schematic diagrams. First, number one, parallel wire line or open wire line. So it is represented with like that. So there are two parallel wires. The signal is transmitted through these cables. The example is considered as power lines. Power lines. Telephone lines, telegraph lines, telegraph lines, telephone, telegraph lines, etc. are considered as parallel wire line or open wire line. If you see the front view of two conductors, the two conductors will lie like dots. The electric field is always from one conductor to another conductor. So the solid line represents the electric field from one conductor to another conductor. So this represents E field. So the magnetic field is always in the form of circles. Around the conductor. So this is your H field. These cables are used up to 1 megahertz. Above 1 megahertz, there will be radiation losses in the cable. This is the first one. Let us see the second one. It is coaxial cable. This is the first one, parallel wire line or open wire line. The second one is coaxial cable. Coaxial cable consisting of an inner conductor and an outer conductor. The signal is transmitted in the inner conductor. Some dielectric medium will be there in between inner conductor and outer conductor. So this represents inner conductor. This represents outer conductor. See, in fact, this is the inner conductor, front view, and this will be the outer conductor. This is the outer conductor. So this is the inner conductor and this is the outer conductor. So let us say the inner conductor diameter is say small d and the outer conductor diameter is say capital D. The electric field is always from inner conductor to outer conductor. The electric field is always from inner conductor to outer conductor. This solid line represents E field. The magnetic field is always in the form of circles. The magnetic field line is always in the form of circles around the inner conductor. So this is H field. This is H field. These cables are useful. Examples of LAN cables are, examples of coaxial cables are LAN cables, LAN cables, CRO probes, etc. These are useful up to these cables. These cables are useful. These cables are useful up to 100 megahertz. Above 100 megahertz, so there will be radiation losses in this cable. Next, third one, twisted pair. Twisted pair. That means a pair of cables are twisted over each other. The pair of cables which are twisted over each other to transmit the signal from one location to another location. Example, again, examples are power cables, etc. Examples, power cables, etc. Now let us check the fourth one. Fourth one, the fourth one is planar type. The fourth one is planar type. The fourth one is planar type. So in planar type, there will be two types. A, rectangular waveguide. A rectangular waveguide. Number B, circular waveguide. Two types. Rectangular waveguide will be shown like this. That means there is a rectangular box, metallic box. In this, the microwave signal is transmitted. Similarly, say this width is say A, height is say B. So let us assume that this is a circular conductor. Circular waveguide, in fact, its radius is A. So these type of structures are used. These structures are used in microwave frequency range. In microwave frequency range from 300 megahertz to 300 GHz, these structures are used to transfer electromagnetic wave. So therefore, electromagnetic wave is transmitted through this rectangular waveguide, and this is your circular waveguide. Next, number five, microstrip line. So microstrip line is also used to in microwave frequency range. Very simple diagram, microstrip line. So the microstrip line consists of a dielectric. Say the microstrip line consists of a dielectric substrate. Dielectric substrate. Over this, there is a small strip. There is a small strip of thickness. Of thickness T and width W. So this is your microstrip. This is your microstrip, and this is your dielectric material. This is your dielectric material with the dielectric constant epsilon R. So this structure is used in microwave integrated circuits. To transfer electromagnetic wave. So the microstrip lines are very cheaper as compared with waveguides. These structures are cheaper when compared to waveguides, when compared to rectangular waveguides and circular waveguides, these structures are very useful microstrip lines, which are very cheap. Now this last next one is wire above the ground. So this structure you use, there is a ground plane. Say this is your ground plane. So this is a ground plane. Some cable will be over this ground plane, and the signal is transmitted through this cable. And some reference plane is used as ground for transmitting the signal through the cable. So this is called as wire above the ground. Next one, last one. Optical fiber cable. So as you know that the optical fiber cable consists of core of refractive index N1 and cladding of refractive index N2. This consists of a core of refractive index N1 and it consists of a cladding of refractive index N2. Generally N1 is greater than N2. The information is transmitted in the form of light in the core. So what are the advantages? The advantages are number one, low losses, large bandwidths, high data rates, etc. So these are the some of the advantages of optical cables in which the information is transmitted in the form of light or in the form of intensity modulation of light. So this is the answer. What are the types of transmission lines? First one, parallel wire line or open wire line. Second one is coaxial cable. Third one is twisted pair. Fourth one is planar type. In the planar type, there are two structures, rectangular waveguide and circular waveguide, microstrip line. So this is the microstrip line structure, which is also used in microwave frequency range. This is the next one, wire above the ground. And last one is optical fiber cable. So these are the different types of transmission lines you have to write in the examination to get full marks in the examination. Thank you.